I ain't even about to play with y'all Ravens. I ain't even about to play with y'all today, man. YouTube team, keep it clean. What's going on? It's Saint Graven here with another video. And in this video, it just seems like we going backwards almost. Because, of course, it came out last night that the Browns, they want to sign Jadeveon Clowney. They're expected to sign Jadeveon Clowney. They're trying to bring him in for a second visit today. And trying to get this thing done today. But, from Jeremy Fowler, just came out that the Colts are among teams keeping tabs on Jadeveon Clowney, but there was another team also keeping tabs on Jadeveon Clowney, that being the Baltimore Ravens. So the Ravens and Colts are among teams keeping tabs on Jadeveon Clowney, but Browns have been the most aggressive to try to get something done. Clowney opted against Cleveland last offseason, but this time feels different. Now, what this also sounds like, you know who this is benefiting the most? Is Jadeveon Clowney. Because if the Ravens and the Colts, they still keeping tabs on him, so they still watching out for him, they still trying to see what's going on with him, that means for the Browns, or really for Jadeveon Clowney period, his market is slowly rising. It's slowly rising. And y'all know how I feel about Jadeveon Clowney, especially being a Ravens fan. It's a move that I wanted to happen a long time ago. I would have loved for the Ravens to get Jadeveon Clowney. Yes, I know the injury history. I know it. Trust me, I do. And I hate it. Hate it for him. Hate it for any NFL player that got to go through that. The potential is there. And like I said yesterday, is Jadeveon Clowney a bit overrated? Yeah, I think he is a little bit. But at the same time, he could still be a difference maker. And he could just... Well, just imagine Jadeveon Clowney. Wink Martindale with Jadeveon Clowney. Like everything he could do with... Because the Ravens and run defense, they already set, man. You know their run defense is going to be straight. But he will make it even better. As a pass rusher, he's cool. He ain't the best pass rusher in the world, but he ain't got to be. But he would definitely bring a lot more speed to the Ravens at the pass rush position than they've had recently. Would he be the end-all, be-all to the pass rush? No, not at all. But he could help set the edge, and he could help drop back. He can do different things, man. So, I do still expect him to sign with the Cleveland Browns. I expect them to get it done. Now, with Jadeveon Clowney, one thing with the Ravens keeping tabs on him, one thing that I would be concerned about, and well, two things, actually, and two reasons I don't expect them to sign Jadeveon Clowney would be, one, the price tag. Because, again, like we said, this, with Ravens and Colts still, with it being put out there that they're still watching him, and this is something that the Browns probably already know. Their front office probably already knows that Jadeveon Clowney, like the other teams are keeping tabs on him. It might be even more. But with those other teams keeping tabs on him, like I said, it drives his market up. But another reason why I think the Ravens won't sign him, comp picks. And this is where it gets very tricky. Now, me, I understand the Ravens, they've been the leaders with getting the most comp picks ever since the comp pick formula came out. I get that, I understand that, I respect that. But sometimes it just seems like Ravens just value these picks so much that they're not willing to take that chance. It seems like, and it's not every time, sometimes they do take chances now. But other times it can be like, man, these dudes just want to hold on to all these comp picks so much that they'll pass up an opportunity on getting a player because they don't want it to, they don't want to lose out on a comp pick. And I just, like I said, it's tricky. There's no right or wrong answer for it, but it just is what it is because some of those comp picks have really worked out. I think Sam Cook was a comp pick. There were some other people too. I think Pernell McPhee, he was a comp pick. We can go down the list another time, but there were some comp picks that really end up working out, and other times they just didn't. But that would be the same way with signing somebody. When you sign somebody, and if they count against the comp pick formula, sometimes it can work out, sometimes it might not. That's just the business of the NFL. It is just what it is. So it's a very tricky spot to be in for the Baltimore Ravens. So they're scheduled to bring in Justin Houston on Tuesday. That's still on for now. With Jadeveon Clowney, I don't expect anything to happen. But it is nice to know that they're keeping tabs on him. But it was said late last week that they really were exploring the free agent pass rusher position. Because it's Jadeveon. They didn't say who else they wanted to bring in. I know Jeff Zrebic did say that they still wanted to bring in some other names. But he didn't list who those names were. He just listed the people that are out there right now that they could possibly have some interest in. And he didn't name Jadeveon Clowney, Kerrigan. Who else was out there too? Justin Houston, obviously. And it's somebody that I'm missing, but I can't think of them off the top of my head. Now, another thing too. Could this be a smokescreen? It could be. It could be a smokescreen. And one of the reasons I think it could be a smokescreen is because if they're keeping tabs on Jadeveon, now last year, it certainly wasn't no smokescreen. They're like, they wanted Jadeveon Clowney, and they were ready to do that Chris Paul Lakers NBA trade that got vetoed and shut down. They were ready to do something like that with the Jacksonville Jaguars. Because if y'all remember, Ravens, they wanted Jadeveon Clowney, but they didn't have the money for him. So what they were going to do was have the Jacksonville Jaguars sign him and then have the Jacksonville Jaguars trade Jadeveon Clowney to the Ravens. So that would have been crazy, man. But they ran it by the league, and the league said no. What they should have done is just done it. They should have just done it. If they would have just done it, league couldn't do nothing about it. They couldn't stop the signing, and they couldn't stop the trade. So the Jaguars would have ate the bonus. And the Ravens would have traded them, I guess, picks and players and whatnot. But obviously, that didn't go through. So it wasn't a smokescreen last year. Because Ravens, they were all in. But now, one reason I say it could possibly be a smokescreen is because you know they're bringing in Justin Houston. And just the timing of this. The timing is everything. They're bringing in Justin Houston. Justin Houston is the free agent. If he knows that he's going into the Baltimore Ravens, and he knows that they're keeping tabs on Jadeveon Clowney, this could really push him to really want to sign even more. Be like, oh, well, they looking at him too? No, I'm better. Look at my numbers. Look at my career. Look what I've done. Even recently, look what I've done. What has he done recently? Whatever he's done recently, it certainly isn't better than me. No, these dudes, they need to want me, and I want them to want me, and I'm going to show them I'm in great shape. I got a great resume. I'm very consistent. I got that over Jadeveon Clowney. Why would they be even still watching him when I'm coming in? So that puts that pressure on him to be like, oh, I got to really show out for these guys. And I have to make sure that I do not leave there without a deal. Now, again, with Justin Houston, the comp pick formula. Same thing, comp pick formula. And that's the thing that worries me the most about this whole thing. Whether it's Jadeveon Clowney, whether it's Justin Houston, whether it's Ryan Kerrigan, whether it's whoever it might be, the comp pick formula. So it's a possibility. It's not likely because we're like, what are we, 17 days away from the draft? Something like that. But it's a possibility, even though it's not likely, that all these guys, if Ravens want to stay true to this comp pick formula, they don't want to lose anymore. It's a possibility that all of those guys are gone. Even though Kerrigan hasn't been getting any noise recently. It's a possibility that they're all gone though. Because you know, every single year, when these guys' names, when the people find out that teams are interested in these guys, that's when their market starts buzzing. That's when it starts buzzing. We ain't been hearing nothing about Jadeveon Clowney. Nothing. Only thing we have been hearing about him is that he was getting healthy. That's it. But all of a sudden, Brown's bringing in Jadeveon, or they brought him in for a visit like a week ago. But now we hear about Browns bringing him in again for another visit. And now we hear about the Colts and the Ravens also keeping tabs on him too. Coincidence? No, I think not. It happens every year. So then with Justin Houston, again, I could see the same thing happening with him too. Ravens bringing him in for a visit. Then don't be surprised if tomorrow we hear that somebody else is interested in him as well. Because those are how those things work. But when that buzz is created around these players, then it boosts up their market and it gets different teams more interested in them. So the possibilities of them being gone, they raise up. Anyway, we'll see what happens. Time is a ticking. So I will keep y'all posted as we find out anything. And I know y'all will keep me posted too. Team Keep It Clean, I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. And we out.